Hi guys, I'm back with a new video, and this time without a hole in my shirt but with yellow fingers because I was working on a health potion and I forgot to wear gloves. I don't know why, but I did, and now I don't know what to do because my nails are covered with orange stains and my fingers are covered with a yellow glow, and I use sea salt, a sea salt scrub, a brush, lemon zest, lemon juice, all these together, and I think I got rid of 50% of the damage, and I need help. So if you have any idea how to get rid of these stains, and put it in the comments below because I need it. So this video is about love spells and lust spells and lust after me spells and come to me spells and stay with me spells and don't go away spells and same-sex spells and opposite-sex spells, and I get a lot of requests from people all over the world that are struggling with love. They fell in love and their desire isn't met, or their love isn't answered, or people were in love and then turned that being in love in an obsession, and they're struggling with that obsession for 3, 4, 5, even 10 years in a row, and others are looking for a spiritual compatible partner. So there are all kinds of people that are interested in these type of spells. Now, you can use a lot of techniques, from glamour weaving to mind control and energy manipulation and Reiki and rituals and spells and working with angels and summoning demons to get what you want. And I don't know, it's love, you know? I don't want to do this video, but I'm going to do it because it's important. We're talking about love, you know? Now the thing is, I've seen a lot of magicians, very experienced magicians and witches and druids, use these techniques sometimes, or very often a combination of all these, and you know, at some point your target or victim will wake up and find herself or himself in a situation and in a relationship where he or she didn't even want to be from the beginning, but through using these techniques ended up in this situation and relationship anyway. And then of course there was a very explosive, nasty, ugly divorce, because well, the target or victim is going to put up a fight, you know, started running and fighting and trying to get away, as far away as possible, and sometimes there were children involved, sometimes there were no children involved, but either way, it was war. So sooner or later, depending on your skills, your love of your life will wake up and end the relationship in a very mean, ugly, nasty way. So then there are the people that were in a relationship and are thinking, well, my previous partner lacked spirituality, so this time I will do better and I find myself a spiritual compatible partner who is also into summoning demons and working with angels and practicing Reiki and doing meditations and at least do some yoga, palm reading and something like mindfulness or something. And they are struggling and fighting and not getting what they want, and they end up all alone and desperate. And then you have the ones that are in a spiritual relationship and they are going crazy because one of them thinks that meditation should be done this way and the other one is arguing that meditation should be done the other way, and then he says that the Reiki hand position should be like this, and she is saying that the hand position should be like that, and then you have a witch that wants to summon a demon the Solomonic way, and she's in a relationship with somebody that wants to do it freestyle. It's just, it's hard, you know. So you have the, let me think, you have the ones that crashed because they used all these techniques. Then you have the ones that were in a, let's say, mundane relationship, and that relationship ended and they are now looking for a spiritual compatible partner but cannot find them. Then there are the ones that are in a spirit, that do have a spiritual partner, but are in a war constantly, and it's just weird. So if you look at this a little bit rational or logical, being in love is something that lasts 3 up to 6 months, and after that you will wake up and go back to normal and everything is normal and all right again, and that's it. But for some odd reason, when love isn't answered, then somebody can get all obsessed and frustrated, and that can lead to using techniques in such a way that it will be a disaster, hell. So that's what you don't want to do. And the thing is that it's a little bit hard to explain this, because what you need in a relationship is friendship, fun, freedom, forgiveness, and if you like to add another F, then you can use fuck. So there you have 5 F's, and they are all very, very important. And if you do a love or lust spell, I don't think, well, you have to, friendship, fun, forgiveness, freedom, and fuck, you know, if that's important to you. But friendship, I think, is something that should be in every relationship. Between, even if somebody is an authority figure, like a teacher and a student, the relationship, there should be at least some kind of friendship, respect. So, anyway, if I were you, I would add, if you choose to use a ritual or a law spell or whatever to get what you want or what you think you want, add these 5 ingredients, because your relationship is doomed from the beginning. And and then another thing with energy manipulation or glamour weaving or mind control or Reiki, you have to keep doing it all the time, year, day in, day out, year after year, non-stop, 24/7, because, you know, we all have these experiences where you fall in love with somebody, and that somebody is also falling in love with you, and in the beginning everything is nice and romantic and sensual and sexual and funny and exciting, and you know, but after 3 months or 3 years, something there in the middle, it starts to get a drag, bore, something lazy and slow, and ladies want to wear beautiful dresses and do their hair and wear makeup and polish their nails and all kinds of wear high heels, and the man is shaving all the time and using deodorant and an expensive aftershave, and goes to the barber or the hairdresser every 2 weeks, and everything looks fine and great and beautiful, and you know, after 3 months or so, you're both on the couch, like a couple of potatoes, wearing a hoodie and wearing dirty socks and having a bowl of popcorn or soup on your belly and just dripping down. And that's how a relationship normally evolves. You go from all bright and shiny and beautiful to you know. And it's not that as soon as you lose the desire to dress up or be funny or create something romantic, that your relationship goes down the drain or will be thrown out of the window. But you know, it's just normal. And another thing that I wanted to make very, very clear is that as soon as you, if you are a witch, a druid, a wizard, a magician, or demolator, you can't just get sloppy or lazy. You have to keep working and going and pushing, because as soon as you go become sloppy or become lazy, then you will lose your charm, you will lose your charisma, then you will just lose everything. And you will lose the love of your life. So I think, I hope this makes sense. So if you work with love, and if you use magic in finding the love of your life, or whatever, friendship, fun, forgiveness, freedom, and fuck, don't ever forget to add these, if you ever, because you know, normally if you bump into people, you have things in common and sometimes you don't. And also another thing I wanted to say about a spiritual compatible partner or being in a spiritual relationship is that I've seen a lot of people being in a spiritual relationship and having a spiritual compatible partner and having fights all the time over mindfulness, meditation, summoning demons, Reiki, crystals, the type of incense, what have you. And so, you know, I have a friend who likes to spend a lot of time in his ritual chamber. And he has a very mundane, normal wife who likes to take care of him and pamper him. And she's used to doing things alone because he is in his ritual chamber doing whatever he is doing. And she makes soup and brings it to his room on a plate. And she knocks on the door to let him know that there's something on the other side of the door. Can be a cup of coffee, can be a cup of tea, can be a bowl of soup or whatever. And sometimes she wants to ask him something and she respectfully slides a piece of paper through under the door. And you know, he loves her for being so sweet and kind. And when he comes out of his ritual room, she gets a cuddle and he will say how nice her dishes were. And it works. So having a spiritual compatible partner doesn't always mean that you end up in a happy and safe and blessed relationship. You might want to consider the complete opposite, to be happy and to become happy and feel blessed. And you know, so a lot of things to think about, and I hope this makes sense. See you next time. Bye.